And in today's Eye on Entertainment, a new movie traces an award-winning reporter's investigation into whether Jesus really is the Son of God. A Case for Christ hits theaters tomorrow. It's a true story based on the worldwide best-selling book by journalist, former journalist Lee Strobel. He's now a teaching pastor. Lee joins us live now from Chicago, along with actor Mike Vogel, who plays Lee in the film. Welcome, gentlemen. Lee, let's start with you. Journalists are by nature skeptical. That's why we do what we do. So tell a little bit about your story for those who have not read your blockbuster book.
Sure. I was an atheist. As you say, being trained in journalism and law makes you a bit skeptical about things, and you want to know evidence and facts. My wife was a spiritual, not so much a skeptic, just spiritually confused. And so we had a similar worldview in that we neither of us believed in God. But then she became a Christian, and I was the angry atheist who was upset about this new development in her life, wanted to get her out of this cult that she got involved in. So I set out to disprove Christianity by showing that the resurrection of Jesus was merely a legend or make-believe.
And man, did you ever? And now, I mean, what's it feel like to have this book that has been such a blockbuster on the big screen? You're going to reach so many more people who just don't take the time to read.
Yeah, I think you're right. There are a lot of people who won't read a 300-page book, or they won't go into a church, but they'll go to a movie where on one level you can be entertained and engaged. It's just a really good movie. It's a great story that Brian Bird put together out of our real-life story.
Yeah.
But on the other level, it's also an enlightening movie because it talks about the evidence for the resurrection.
I love that. Mike, how hard is it as an actor to play somebody? I mean, you're sitting next to the guy that you've portrayed. That's got to be a little intimidating.
Yeah, I mean, intimidating, but also it also helps you, I think, as the actor to have a flesh and blood human there, and especially the person who you are portraying, to walk you through what they may or may not have been feeling at these moments, to catch, you know, moments in the Chicago Tribune as we've recreated the Tribune, to have input to make it that much more authentic.
Yeah.
But I had a personal connection to the book myself, and so that just made it that much more important that we got it right.
So playing Lee, do for your personal faith journey, if anything?
I read the book when I was 17, and I was always a big fan of history, and it was the first time in my life where, you know, you sort of depart from the faith of your fathers and you have to find that belief for yourself. Reading this book, it gave me tangible things in history that I can point to that you know, as Lee says, it's investigatable, and facts that can be proven, historical facts. So faith is a bit of an intangible. It takes whatever side of the argument you land on, it takes a certain amount of the unknown.
Mm-hmm.
What the book did is it took a lot of the unknown out of it for me and made it easier to get to that faith leap. And so now, later in life, having the opportunity to put that on screen is a real honor.
I love that. I cannot wait. I've read the book as well. Cannot wait to see the film. Thank you so very much, both of you, for bringing this project to the masses.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mary Beth. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Case for Christ. AC.